Amelia and Josh met via two friends of theirs, Brad and Beck. This is around 2011. Josh was at SAFM and Amelia was a nanny. Being in radio, Josh showed off by telling Amelia that he gets free stuff and that some of that was tickets to the movies. So they went off to see their first movie together, the 2011 classic Bridesmaids. However, Josh forgot to take the free tickets, so the show-off date wasn't exactly very show-offy at all. But Josh asking Amelia to marry him didn't quite go as smoothly as either of them hoped. Firstly, several days before Christmas 2015, it was Amelia's birthday, and she thought, this just might be the night Josh proposes. They got themselves ready, Amelia taking a bit of extra special time to make sure she looked just right. And as they were leaving, she looked at him excitedly and said, have you got everything? Josh looked at his keys and his phone in his hand and he said, yep. It was only later during the evening when Amelia got a little quiet at dinner that Josh realised she might have been expecting a little more than his phone and keys to be on the table. And opened it again for her to continue flipping the pages, where the fourth to last page read 4 years, the third to last page read 3 months, the second to last page read 22 days, and the last page said, one life together, marry me, Amelia Purvis. Finally, a ring was produced. Now, when it came to planning the proposal, Cal knew from the start that it was going to be pretty difficult to get anything past Hannah. She could actually be a spy as another job if she wanted to. You can't hide anything in the house or in the bank account. So he had to set up an almost elaborate money laundering system to hide money as he saved for the ring, for starters. There were a few false starts with the engagement. Now let me just say, this is Hannah's version. One of these was the holiday in New Zealand at the end of 2015 when Cal made Hannah climb a glacier in thongs. She wasn't keen but thought, oh well, maybe he wants to propose to me at the top. Hadn't even crossed his mind. Then there was the trip to Bali in September 2016. Hannah thought he might do it at the airport so he could claim the tax on the ring like any good accountant would. But a trip to the loo got in the way and nothing happened at the airport. Hannah almost gave up. But on their first morning in Bali, Cal woke up, made the coffee, set the camera to record and let Hannah know that the coffee was ready in the living area of their villa in Bali. Out she came, and there it was, finally, a ring. At a time that she didn't expect. No mean feat on Cal's behalf. But to this day, Cal wakes up every morning and brings Hannah coffee in bed. Hannah makes Cal's lunch every day, and they never go to bed without each other.
When I asked Adrian what the most comforting thing about Mel was, he said, just knowing she'll always be there, no matter what. Mel said, it's his cuddles that are the most comforting thing, and some special leg maneuver thing he does with his foot while he's cuddling. I'm with you. It sounded like too much information, so I just left it.
Melissa. You walked down the aisle today to the song we know as Tale as Old as Time by Beauty and the Beast.
Good afternoon, Zoo visitors. Refunded, you become a zoo friend. Zoo friends receive a whole range of benefits.
By the way, are there any zoo friends here?
There is actually, yeah.
Well, you should be paying attention. Okay, we might start from the top. That was just a practice.
Melissa.
This story started back on April 3, 2007, when Harriet sent out a group all email offering two tickets to a concert. And Rowan, who had freshly moved to Melbourne and was trying to find his feet, some would say trying to find his leg. Okay, that's the only dad joke I'm going to do.
That's a goodie though.
Anyway, back to the concert. I think it was, what, Backstreet Boys, New Kids on the Block.
Something
that
similar. Yeah.
Rowan presented himself at the promotions desk to claim his tickets, and the promo chick looked up and thought, hello. How do I know it was April 3, 2007? Because that very email is framed and on the wall at home. Not my home, there. Now, some say that Harriet was kept causing the problems with the computer so that she could have an excuse to see Rowan. Others say Rowan was hacking into it from the IT department to create an issue so that he could get back under a desk. To this day. Remember, you're out. To this day, nobody is really sure. However, personally, having worked for Austereo, I'm placing a bet that it was probably just the fact that SCA was still on Windows version 1.